Dear colleagues, dear friends, good afternoon. I'm glad to be here in Cairo for this important meeting. I will address the topic of heart failure and hypertension. In fact, heart failure is one of the most important and frequent consequences of hypertension inappropriately managed. Hypertension, in fact, is a leading cause for heart failure. Almost 8% of patients with heart failure has had past or is actually an hypertensive patient. The good news is that if we treat appropriately hypertension, reducing blood pressure by pharmacological treatment, we may prevent heart failure by a large extent. And this is particularly true in the elderly population. Most of the drugs used in hypertension are effective in preventing heart failure, including ACE inhibitor, angiotensin receptor blocker, beta blockers, and diuretics. Perhaps calcium antagonists seems a bit less effective, but when they are given in combination with diuretics, beta blockers, and the other drugs, they seem to be similarly effective as the other antihypertensive drugs. Heart failure can develop with the hemodynamic characteristics of a reduced ejection fraction, as well as with normal ejection fraction. In the first case, the so-called heart failure with reduced ejection fraction, the heart is enlarged and systolic function is severely depressed. With normal ejection fraction, the heart usually not enlarged, but often hypertrophic. There is a diastolic dysfunction more than systolic dysfunction. For patients with heart failure and reduced ejection fraction, we have several drugs that have been demonstrated to be able to improve the symptoms, to increase the well-being, and also to reduce the morbidity and mortality. And these include ACE inhibitor or angiotensin receptor blockers, beta blockers, and mineral corticoid receptor antagonists. Diuretics should be always given in order to reduce the symptoms. Recently, a new class of drugs, angiotensin receptor neprilysin inhibitors, has been found even more effective than ACE inhibitor and angiotensin receptor blockers in improving the symptoms and increasing the life duration in these patients. On the contrary, in patients with heart failure preserved ejection fraction, we have no drug that has been demonstrated to reduce the mortality. We may improve the symptoms, but it's very difficult to obtain the same result as in patients with heart failure and reduced ejection fraction. These patients are always quite often hypertensive. They are usually women, elderly women, and they have many comorbidities. It's very important to diagnose the comorbidities and treat them accordingly. So more research is needed in these patients in order to find the best management. In any case, what is clear is that an appropriate treatment of hypertension, reduction of blood pressure, has the most important role in preventing heart failure. And preventing heart failure is the best way to make our patients live longer.